form associations is a tremendous amount of research into just how valuable reading alone is. There's many other brain activities. I used to give my patients these games, Brain 81, Brain 82. They're very fun and tender type of games. They give you a score of how well you do. But you know, things have moved on from there. Today, even though I don't possess an iPhone, I will soon. There are now over 600 million iPhone applications, and there's many fun games on iPhone apps. One of them that I came across recently is Words with Friends. These are all very, very clever games, and the point about them is not only do they evolve all the time, but it's much cheaper. If you already have an iPhone, you don't need to buy an Nintendo for $100. So things are moving very quickly. There's also web-based games that you can use. Now, I mentioned something about sleep. Sleep is not only important for respiratory function, just that you feel right the next day, but if you don't sleep properly, you're prone to depression, you have no energy levels, you can't concentrate, you cannot remember properly. You're also putting yourself at risk of stroke and heart attack and a number of other things. Those people who are particularly badly affected, for example, by sleep apnea and snoring, this dramatically impairs your brain function. And this can be treated, yes, with CPAP in the short term, but the long-term measure is to reduce the back pain and snoring equivalent. Even napping in the afternoon is extremely beneficial. They are called power naps by some people. There's a big study from Greece that was published just 1 or 2 years ago that if you have a regular nap in the afternoon, you reduce your chance of cardiac events, in other words, a heart attack, by 37%. Now, these are huge numbers just from napping in the afternoon. And of course, the Latin people call this a siesta. There's a tremendous amount of research about brain foods, and it's a big topic on its own, but just as a quick summary, fruit and vegetables are extremely important for everybody. They have a huge number of antioxidants in them. Some fruits are more potent than others, we know that. And even cocoa, tea, coffee, and chocolate. For example, chocolate just in the last week was shown to reduce stroke by 20%. You have to be careful of what kind of chocolate. Got to have at least 30% cocoa, fat content mustn't be too high, etc. Fish and red meats, white meats, very important in the diet. Meat are brain juice for us. That's what we did when we jumped down from the trees. So it allowed our brains to enlarge in the first place. Even